Hey everybody, this is Mark from Kryptvisor. Here we are in the city of Heidelberg, and we are at the Christmas market, as you can probably tell. It is getting cold, and the season is upon us. Now, we are out here again to speak with people today, randomly, out on the streets, and try to find out if they really do care about their privacy. And, if they do, why are they using the messaging apps that they're using? So, why don't you come along with me, and perhaps we will run into some crazy elves and maybe some reindeer and maybe the fat jolly man himself. So, let's go.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
You use an instant messenger.
Yeah.
Yes.
WhatsApp. Yeah, yes.
You use WhatsApp.
Mm-hmm.
And you?
And the Facebook Messenger as well.
Okay. And who owns WhatsApp?
Facebook.
Right, right. Yeah. How does WhatsApp make any money? How could they offer a service for free if they just give it away?
I don't know.
It is a good
sense.
Question. I never thought about it.
Most people don't think about it.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah.
They
sell your data.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. Yeah, it makes sense.
Have you ever looked at the privacy policy of WhatsApp?
No. Really. They should have a legal plan to operate, you know?
Well, they do. And it says in black and white, by you using
data.
Our service...
We sell your data.
Sure. And you give us access to everyone in your contact
list. But what data do I have in Facebook and WhatsApp?
You have your contacts.
My contacts.
Sure. And they sell all of this information to third parties. You have given them the names of the people in your contact list.
Yeah.
You have given them the phone numbers.
Yeah,
of the people in your contact list without realizing it. In the world that we live in today, data
is
so important.
Power and money.
It's a good point you make.
We're out here basically asking people what type of instant messenger they use.
Of course, WhatsApp, and also the Facebook Messenger.
Okay.
Telegram.
Do you care about your privacy?
Yeah, I try it.
Have you ever read the privacy policy?
For WhatsApp?
Yeah,
one time ago, but it's years ago.
Years ago. And who owns WhatsApp?
Zuckerberg, I think. Yeah,
Facebook.
So, Facebook.
And
this is a problem because I always know on Facebook.
Yeah.
I was a little bit afraid because they know my mobile phone number.
Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Do you believe people have a human right to privacy?
Yeah, sure, definitely.
What messaging app do you use?
I knew that was coming. Facebook Messenger.
Facebook Messenger, okay. So, you've basically sold away your right to privacy for the use of an app, correct?
Yes, I have.
And how does it make you feel?
A little bit used.
When we finally say goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you'll only hold me tight.
My question to you is, do you care about your privacy?
Yeah, I do. I do.
Really?
Yeah, I do.
Are these just words, or do you really care about it?
Yeah, I do. I do. I do care about it.
What instant messenger do you use?
What do you mean, instant messenger? What I use for texting?
Yeah.
Your WhatsApp messenger. I know. I know. Okay, I know what you... Okay, I know. I get the point.
Do you think more and more people are starting to wake up to the realization that companies are monetizing your data and you have given away your right to privacy for the use of an app?
I think they are, slowly.
Yeah.
Spoken to people older than me that have no idea that all this data is being collected on them and what the end goal of most of this free software is, to collect user data for advertising, et cetera, et cetera.
Right. Can I read your text messages?
No.
Why not? You have just given WhatsApp, Facebook, access to everything you write, and you won't let me see it? That's okay. A lot of people are...
You got a point there.
Do you think people would be willing to use an instant messaging app that A, is anonymous, the company has no idea who you are, they don't have your email address, they don't have your mobile number, the company has no data on you whatsoever.
Yeah, people will use it.
What instant messenger do you use?
I use WhatsApp, Facebook Messenger.
And I just use WhatsApp and Facebook Messenger.
Okay. Okay.
Yes, me too. But I like only WhatsApp Messenger.
Do you value your own privacy?
Yeah.
Yes.
Do you?
I try, yes.
Would it be okay if you gave me your phone and I read your messages?
I don't think so, no.
No. Could I read your messages?
No, I'm sorry. I know what's your...
What I'm getting to,
yes.
Okay.
So, because the people who makes the WhatsApp account can read all of the messages and can look in your account and privacy and the number, yes,
I know. So then, you don't really care too much about your privacy, do you?
When we finally say goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you'll only hold me tight.
And we never ask ourselves, how do these companies make any money? They have employees.
Mm-hmm.
They have to pay programmers. They have huge buildings.
Mm-hmm.
And yet they give the service away for free? How is that possible?
It's a good question.
They have to be making money somehow. How do you think they make their money?
Maybe they sell our private stuff.
I think it's more than maybe. A lot of people talk about the right to privacy.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people say that it's very important.
Mm-hmm.
It's very important that I can retain my personal information.
Mm-hmm.
However, we have basically given away this right to use a free service. Do you think people are now becoming a little bit more aware and realizing, you know what? These companies should be paying me to actually use their service because they are making money off of me.
I'm not sure if they should pay me. It would be nice at least, but...
Well, how do they make their money?
I know how they make the money.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm paying with my privacy.
Right,
so
right.
That's the thing, so it isn't actually for free.
Here we were in Heidelberg at the Christmas market. We got to speak to some people. Very nice people. Very fun people. And... we've come up with the conclusion that a lot of people would pay for a secure messenger. And I think it's just the changing of the times, and because more and more people have become aware that we have all become a product. And these free services that they use cost a lot more than just the change in their pocket. They're costing them their right to privacy. And this is something that most people, that when we all spoke to, they all believed that it was a human right. And they've all agreed that, yeah, we've given it away for a free application. And this is a good sign, not just for Cryptvisor, but this is a good sign itself in general, that people are waking up to this. And I believe this is a wave, that this will progress in the future. So hopefully next time we'll be in another area of the world, who knows. But until that time, have a nice holiday, and we'll see you later. Ciao.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you'll really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm.